यस्याभवद्भक्तजनातिहन्दुगुभृत्तमन्येष विचार्यतूर्णं स्तम्भेवदारस्तमनन्यलभ्यं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपत्ते गोबिले गरुडशैलमध्ये कृपावशात् कल्पिरसन्निधानं लक्ष्म्या समालिङ्गितवामबाहं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपत्ते श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहपरब्रह्मणे नमः अस्मद्गुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत्सर्वगुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत्परमगुरुभ्यो नमः श्रीमदे श्रीयादिवञ्चडगोविरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमदे श्रीवञ्चडगोप श्रीवेदान्तदेशिकरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहदिव्यपादुका सेवक श्रीवञ्चडगोप श्रीनारायण इदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमदे श्रीवञ्चडगोप श्रीरङ्गनाथ इदीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय जन्मात्यसयदोन्वयादितरदस्सात्तेष्वभिज्ञस्वराट् तेने ब्रह्महृदाय आदिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः तेजो वारिमृदां यदा विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषां धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तगुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि निगमकल्पधरोर्कळिदं फलं शुगमुखादमुदद्रवसंयुधं पिबदभागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नन्दनाय च नन्दगोपकुमाराय गोविन्दाय नमो नमः नमः पङ्कजनाभाय नमः पङ्कजमालिने नमः पङ्कजनेत्राय नमस्ते पङ्कजाङ्ग्रये வேதத்தை வேதத்தின் சுவைப்பயனை விழுமிய முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார்களிற்றை குவலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லா மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமையிலை திருவல்லிக்கேனி கண்டேனே ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரியம் கவிதார்க்கிகேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரியபரிஹோமி சந்நிதத்தாம் சதா ஹிருதி வந்தே பிருந்தாவனசரம் வல்லவி ஜனவல்லபம் ஜயந்தி சம்பவம் தாம வைஜயந்தி விபூஷணம் வசுதேவசுதம் தேவம் கம்சசாணூரமர்தனம் தேவகீ பரமானந்தம் கிருஷ்ணம் வந்தே ஜகத்குரும் தும் து சர்வம் பரித்தியச்ச ஸ்நேகம் ஸ்வஜனபந்துஷு மயாவேஷ்ய மனசம்யக்கு சமத்ருக் விசரஸ்வகாம் எதிதம் மனசா வாச்சாம் சக்ஷுர்பியாம் ஸ்ரவணாதிபிஹி நஸ்வரம் க்ருஹ்யமாணஞ்ச வித்தி மாயா மனோமயம் பும்சோ யுக்தஸ்ய நானார்த்தோ பிரமச குணதோஷபாக் கர்மா கர்ம விகர்மேதி குணதோஷ தியோபிதா தஸ்மாத் யுக்திரேந்திய கிராமோ யுக்தசித்த இதம் ஜகது ஆத்மநீஷஸ்வவிததம் ஆத்மானம் மையதீஸ்வரே ஞான விஜான சம்யுக்த ஆத்மபூத ஷரீரினாம் ஆத்மானுபவ துஷ்டாத்மா நாந்தராயைர் விஹன்யசே தோஷபுத்தியோ பயாதீதோ நிஷதான்ன நிவர்த்ததே குணபுத்தியாச்ச விகிதம் ந கரோதி யதார்பக சர்வபூத சுகிருத் சாந்தோ ஞான விஜான நிச்சய பஷ்யன் மதாத்மகம் விஸ்வம் ந விபத்யேத வை புனஹ தஸ்மாத் த்வம் உத்தவ உத்ஸ்ருஜ்ய சோதனாம் பிரதிச்சோதனாம் பிரவிருத்திம் ச நிவிருத்திம் ச ஸ்ரோதவ்யம் ஸ்ருதமேவ ச மாம் ஏகமேவ சரணம் ஆத்மானம் சர்வதேஹினாம் யாகி சர்வாத்ம பாவேன மயா சோ ஹெகுதோ பயஹ வியரஞ்சாங் தி உத்தவ கீதா டுடே இஸ் தி 159th லெக்சர் and we are on the 11th skandam 13th adhyayam if you are looking at the Uddhava Gita it is the 8th chapter Sanagadis asked the question to Brahma, their father, why the mind goes to the things on temptation? Why the things and the people attract our mind? A mumukshu, ordinary people don't have to worry about it. A mumukshu wants to go to the moksham. How he can get away from all these entanglements? Brahma did not know the answer, so he prayed to his father Bhagavan, and Bhagavan appeared as a Hamsa Rubam, Hamsavatara. At that time, Sanagadis posed the question, Ka Bhavan, who are you? Bhagavan answered that one with 3 slokas and then continued to answer the rest of the questions what he was asking about what the mumukshu can do about the temptation to go to the moksham. So that is where the Hamsagita starts. We have seen the first 2 slokas and the 3rd sloka we will continue today. In a nutshell, in the first 2 sloka, Vastuno yatyanna natvam atmana prashna yitrishaha kadam gadedavo vibra vakturva mega ashrayaha. Amazing slogans, three slogans. If you are thinking that Krishna put 7 slogans all the tattvam, Hamsavataram in 3 slogas he puts all of them. So we will look all the 3 together today, try to understand the Sharirika Shastram, what Swami is saying. Bhagavan answering the question, if you are thinking all the Atmas are just one, because Brahman is the only thing that stays, that is what Veda says. So, if Brahman is the one, means you think everything is a one Atma. Atmana vastuna yadi a nanatva. Nanatvana manifold, and nanatva means not manifold. The Atma vastu is not multifold. There are not many Atmas, if you are thinking like that. Immediately we said, our Acharyas very beautifully answered that one. Aru sonna vartai, Kanchipuram, Perurulal Perumal, Tirkachi Nambagal went and asked him. And the second one he was saying, Darsanam Vedam Evacha. Our Darsanam is separate one, 2 of them. That means basically Jivatma and the Paramatma, they are different. So, never equate Bhagavan to the Jivatma. That is what we are understanding. Darsanam Vedam Evacha. So, next one he was asking, what is the protection for me? Who is holding me? Who is supporting me? Me Bhaktugu Ka Ashrayaha. So, there he says, Ahameva Param Tattvam. I am the final. So, if Sanagadis have a question, they can ask Brahma. If Brahma does not know, he can ask Bhagavan. If Bhagavan does not know, he cannot go to anybody else. He is the last. So, you should know everything. So, Bhagavan, unparalleled, unsurpassed, he is the Supreme God, he is the Adi Bijam, and he is the cause of everything. So, that is what we understand. Me Bhaktugu Ka Ashrayaha. When he says like that, Srashta, Dehi, Sunishta. So, the 3rd one he says is Sunishta. Srashta, Bhagavan, does the Srishti Karyam. Dehi, he is the Atma inside. Everything is the Degam for him. And when you are asking, who is supporting the Bhagavan? Sunishta, he is supporting himself. That is what in the Adhikarana Saravali, Desikan says about the Sri Bhashyam, all the 16 Padams. So, continuing on, Vaha Prashna Yitrushaha Kadam Kadeyate. So, Vibra, a scholars, my friends, Vidwans, if you are asking who am I, and if you are believing I am also another Jivatma just like you, an individual soul who is compressed into a small space, Anuttvam and everything, and there is no ultimate difference between you and me, that's not correct. Because Paramatma is the only thing, Brahman is the only thing stays. It says, very good, we accept that. See, here, very beautifully, Hamsavataram going to put all contradictory things and trying to say how you had to reconcile the Veda Vakyams and everything. That is why. So, I am the ultimate, I am the cause of everything. I don't have any support. I am the support for myself. Support, control, own. All of them is myself. So that is what in the first sloka I said. In the second sloka, Panjatmageshu Bhudeshu Samaneshu Cha Vastudaha Ko Bhavaniriva Prashnaha Vacha Rambo Hayardhanaha. భూదేషు పంచాత్మకేషు వస్తుదహ సమానేషు చ ఆల్ ది బాడీస్ యువర్స్ అండ్ హర్స్ అండ్ హిస్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ మేడ్ ఆఫ్ పంచభూతం సో ఇఫ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ ది సేమ్ రా మెటీరియల్ వై దర్ ఇస్ ఎ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ యువర్ బాడీ మై బాడీ అండ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ సో ఎసెన్షియలీ ఆల్ ది ఐటమ్స్ వీ సీ టేబుల్ చైర్ అండ్ ది ఫుడ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అలాంగ్ విత్ మై బాడీ ఇన్ యువర్ బాడీ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ ది సేమ్ కే భవాన్ ఇది వప్రశ్నః అనర్థః సో ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ హూ ఆర్ యూ దట్ ఈస్ ఎ మీనింగ్లెస్ సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈ సేయింగ్ అండ్ ది సెకండ్ వన్ ఫస్ట్ యూ థాట్ దర్ ఈస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఆత్మ విన్ సనగాదిస్ కేమ్ ఈ వాస్ ఆన్స్ ఆస్కింగ్ యూ థాట్ దర్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ వన్ ఆత్మ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ మ్యానిఫోల్డ్ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ ఓకే దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ట్రూ నౌ యు ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ Who am I? That is the second question you are asking. I am trying to tell you, I am the Paramatma. That is about the Atma Vishayam. First sloka, not one Atma, many Atmas are there. And there is nobody supporting me. That means Jivatma, Paramatma are two different things. So he is talking about in the Atma Vishayam. Now, Panjatmageshu, when he says about Panjabhudangal and everything, he is talking about the Shariram. All the Sharirams are made up of Prakriti. In fact, all of them are identical raw material. Only the manifestations are different. Clay is a raw material. Whether you get a pot or a plate, that's a manifestation. Gold is a raw material. Whether you get a necklace or a bracelet or a bangle, that is all manifestations. So this is what he was saying. Vacha arambaha hi. Your body, my body and everything only by vak, by words. Because it has got a shape and it has got a name. Nama, rubam. Otherwise, ring, necklace, ear stud, bangle, all are different. But they are all only by vak, only by words. Essentially what you are seeing basically gold. So, like in the Namarvar says, Kadal Nyalam Seidene Avene Indrum, you take a part and ask him, what is this? He says a part. And you take that one and put it down, throw it and it into the pieces. What do you see now? He says a clay. If the broken piece becomes a clay, this becomes a part. It is the same material, but it has got a different manifestation. So, Vacharambanam Vigaro Namadeyam Ritigetyeva Satyam. Here, Amsavadaram wants to show that Chantokya Upanishad connection. There, all the materials are made by Prithivi, Appu, Tejas, Vayu, Akasha, and all the five Panjabhudas and everything. And that is what you are getting. So, whether you are talking about Panjabhudam, your body, her body, chair, table, all of them same, just like the gold manifested, Panchabhudam manifested over here. So, can you distinguish one Sariram from another Sariram? Of course, we are telling it's tall, it's a male, it's a female, it's a black, it's a white, it's yellow, all those kinds of things you say, those are all immaterial. They're all made from the same thing. The first sloka says, if you think everything is one, sorry, you are wrong. It is many. The Atmas are many. The second sloka, if you think everything is different, your body, his body, her body and everything, sorry, you are wrong. Everything is the same. How beautifully he answers that one. Initially, you think Atma is one. No, you are wrong. Now, second one, you think I am different, he is different, his body is different. You are thinking that one, Shariram part of that one. You are wrong, all of them same. So, he gives a contradictory kind of thing, what normally people may think. The Tattva Jnanam he is giving, basically Tattva Trayam has got three things. So, Hamsa Bhagavan is telling in the first sloka, ఆత్మాస్ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్, దెన్ ఈ షోయింగ్ జీవాత్మ అండ్ పరమాత్మ. దట్ ఈస్ వెరీ షోయింగ్ ఇన్ ది సెకండ్ వన్. శరీరం మేడ్ అప్ ప్రకృతి దట్ ఈస్ కామన్, ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఎ క్లే ఆర్ ఎ గోల్డ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ కామన్ వన్, ఎవ్రీబడి ఈస్ మేనిఫెస్టింగ్ ఇట్ టు దట్. దట్ ఈస్ అబౌట్ ది అనాత్మ ఈస్ టాకింగ్, అచేతనం. ఫస్ట్ స్లోగా అబౌట్ ది ఆత్మ, వెర్ దర్ ఆర్ టూ ఆత్మాస్ ఆర్ దేర్. సెకండ్ స్లోగా అబౌట్ ది అచేతనం. సో విన్ యు ఆర్ టేకింగ్ ఏస్, అచేతన చేతన ఈశ్వర వస్తు, ఆల్ ది థింగ్స్ ఈ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ టాక్డ్. సనగాదీస్ మైట్ హ్యావ్ అండర్స్టూడ్ దిస్ వన్, ది బేసిక్స్, ఆత్మ అనాత్మ వివేకం. బట్ దే ఆర్ స్టిల్ కన్ఫ్యూజ్డ్, దే ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ హూ ఆర్ యూ, హూ ఆర్ యూ మీన్స్ వాట్. సీ ఇన్ ది ఫస్ట్ స్లోగా యూ సెడ్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో రిఫ్యూజ్ ఫర్ యూ, దెర్ ఇస్ నో బడి సపోర్ట్స్ యూ, దెర్ ఇస్ నో రెస్టింగ్ ప్లేస్ ఫర్ యూ. సో వీ ఆల్ గో టు బ్రహ్మ, బ్రహ్మ గోస్ టు యూ, బట్ యూ సెడ్ యూ డోంట్ గో టు ఎనీబడి. సో యాక్చువల్లీ హూ ఆర్ యూ? యు ఆర్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది జీవాత్మ లైక్ అస్, బట్ యు హ్యావ్ ఆల్ ది ఆన్సర్స్, ఆర్ యు ఆర్ ఎ లిటిల్ హైయర్ లెవెల్ జీవాత్మ? వాట్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ యు ఆర్, దట్ ఈస్ వేర్ దే ఆర్. సీ నౌ దే అండర్స్టాండ్ వెన్ యూ గో టు ది క్లాస్ ఇన్ లెక్చర్ హాల్ వేర్ ది ప్రొఫెసర్ ఈస్ దేర్. సో ప్రొఫెసర్ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్, యు ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్ వెన్ యూ ఆర్ లుకింగ్ అట్ దట్ వన్ హౌ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్. Only thing is got more knowledge. Other than that, what it is? So these Sanagadis don't understand, because you are trying to answer the question, that means you are a professor, we are the students, that's all the relation. Is there anything more different? How you are different than us? That is what they were asking for that. So that answer Bhagavan is giving in the third one. So what he was saying, the first one, Atma Vishayam. సెకండ్ వన్ అనాత్మ విషయం. ఫస్ట్ వన్ జీవాత్మ పరమాత్మ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ థింగ్, సెకండ్ స్లోగా అబౌట్ ది శరీరం ప్రకృతి అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్. నౌ ది ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్, వెన్ భగవాన్ ఇస్ స్టాండింగ్ ఇన్ ఫ్రంట్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ ఇన్ హంస రూపం, దే సీ ది బౌండరీ ఆఫ్ హిమ్, ది బౌండరీ ఆఫ్ హిమ్, సీ యూ సీ ది బౌండరీ ఆఫ్ మీ, సో 6 feet టాల్ అండ్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఎ, యూ సీ దిస్ ఈస్ ది పర్సన్, సో యూ థింక్ దట్స్ ఆల్ ది పర్సన్. So Hamsa is standing there, that is why they are asking, that's all you are, and you got only the knowledge, you got more money, or you got more beauty, more character, who are you? That is what the question they are asking. Very beautiful question. Sanagadi is, they want to point out, Bhagavan is different and Bhagavan is the same. That is what they want to bring that. So here the third question, third sloka. మనస వచస దృష్ట్యా గృహ్యదే అన్యైరభీంద్రియై అహమేవ నమత్త అన్యత్ ఇది బుద్ధ్యత్వమంజస. మనస వచస దృష్ట్యా గృహ్యదే, వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ హి సేస్. సో ఫార్ హంసావతారం హి సెడ్ హిస్ సోల్, పరమాత్మ తత్వం ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్ అదర్స్. Your body, look at this, his soul and your soul different, he told. Then he showed your body, basically, Jeevatma Shariram is made up of Prakriti, Tattvatrayam, he told. So now they are looking at him, how about your body? You are like this one, into probably about 6 feet tall and 2 feet wide or whatever it is, that's all it is. How about your body? That is the answer they need. So that is what he is going to say. Now he says, my body is Vyabhagatvam, okay? That one manifests the Prakriti everywhere. Don't think, I am just a little smarter than you. I am little richer than you. I am a little high quality characters than you. If you put all the superlative degrees, the end of that one is me. Still it cannot explain that. See, Vedanta Vakyams, the reason why Hamsa puts that way, he wants to show on the outset, Vedanta Vakyams will confuse you. And I give you a small example with 3 slokas. And now tell me, what do you understand from that? So we are interpreting from the Visishtadvaita Siddhantam, we say something. సేమ్ త్రీ శ్లోకాస్ యూ గో అండ్ గివ్ ఇట్ టు సంబడి అద్వైతం దే విల్ ఇంటర్ప్రెట్ డిఫరెంట్లీ ఇఫ్ యూ గివ్ ఇట్ ది మాధ్వ దెన్ దే విల్ ఇంటర్ప్రెట్ డిఫరెంట్లీ సో యూ వాంట్స్ టు షో దిస్ ఈస్ హౌ ఆల్ ది వేదాంత వాక్యంస్ ఆర్ సో యూ హ్యావ్ టు కరెక్ట్లీ ఇంటర్ప్రెట్ దెమ్ వేదాంత వాక్యంస్ అపారెంట్లీ కన్ఫ్లిక్టింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు రికన్సైల్ దమ్ వీ సా సో మెనీ ప్లేసెస్ ఇన్ శ్రీభాష్యం ది హోల్ శ్రీభాష్యం ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ పూర్వపక్షి సేస్ అపరెంట్ అండ్ వాట్ ఈస్ అవర్ సిద్ధాంతం సేస్ ఏగో హవై నారాయణ ఆసీత్ న బ్రహ్మానయే సనహ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఇట్ సేస్ బిఫోర్ ఆల్ ది సృష్టి నారాయణ ఇస్ అలోన్ దేర్ అసదేమే అసత్ ఏవ దట్ ఈస్ ఓన్ సేస్ హిరణ్య గర్ప ఏవ దట్ ఇస్ అనదర్ ఓన్ సేస్ సో వన్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ సేస్ నారాయణ వాస్ దేర్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ సేస్ అసత్ వాస్ దేర్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ సేస్ బ్రహ్మ వాస్ దేర్ ఇస్ ఇట్ వన్ ఆర్ మెనీ ఆర్ యూ టాకింగ్ నారాయణ ఆర్ యూ టాకింగ్ ఎవ్రీబడి ఎల్స్ దట్ ఈస్ వేర్ ది కన్ఫ్యూషన్ హ్యాపెన్స్ సో దట్స్ వాట్ వీ టోల్డ్ ఇన్ ది శ్రీభాష్యం టేక్ అ లుక్ అట్ హియర్ మనసా ఏవ ఆప్తవ్యం దర్ ఇస్ వన్ శృతి వాక్యం ఈ సేస్ ఏష అను ఆత్మా చేదస వేదిదవ్య ఎన్ మనసాన మన్యదే మనసా ఏవ ఇదం ఆప్తవ్యం మనసా ఏవ ఇదం ఆప్తవ్యం యూ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ భగవాన్ ఓన్లీ త్రూ యువర్ మనసు ఓకే యదో వాచో నివర్తందే అప్రాప్య మనస సహ ఆనందం బ్రహ్మణో విద్వాన్ నపిబేది కుదశ్చనేది అనదర్ ఓన్ సేస్ యూ విల్ నెవర్ అండర్స్టాండ్ భగవాన్ బై మనసు ఈస్ బియాండ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ సేస్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ బై మైండ్ ది అదర్ ఓన్ సేస్ యూ విల్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ బై మైండ్ వాట్ డస్ ఇట్ రియలీ మీన్ సో ఆల్ ది వేదాంత వాక్యంస్ ఆర్ డెలిబరేట్లీ గివెన్ లైక్ దట్ దే డోంట్ వాంట్ టు స్పూన్ ఫీడ్ యూ వాట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ వితౌట్ మైండ్ వీ విల్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ భగవాన్ మైండ్ ఈస్ వాట్ బుద్ధి బుద్ధి ఈస్ వాట్ యువర్ ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ విత్ ది ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఎక్సర్సైజ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ వన్ లెట్ సే ఇఫ్ యూ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ది ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం వేర్ వు యూ గోంట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ యూ విల్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ త్రూ ఎనీథింగ్ ఎల్స్ సో ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం ఈస్ నీడెడ్ సో వీ టోల్డ్ ధర్మీ జ్ఞానం నోస్ ఓన్లీ అబౌట్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ అండ్ ఐఎమ్ ఎ స్లేవ్ టు ది భగవాన్ బట్ దట్ ధర్మీ జ్ఞానం టు అండర్స్టాండ్ యూ నీడ్ ఎ క్వాలిటీ ఆఫ్ ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం ఆహా దిస్ ఈస్ వాట్ ది సబ్స్టెన్స్ ఈస్ సేయింగ్ ఐ అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ వన్ నౌ ఐ హ్యాడ్ గోన్ డూ ప్రభక్తి యూ డూ ప్రభక్తి ఓన్లీ బికాస్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఎ గుడ్ ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం సో యూ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ భగవాన్ ఓన్లీ త్రూ ధర్మబోధ జ్ఞానం ఓన్లీ త్రూ బుద్ధి ఓన్లీ త్రూ మనసు ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ సేమ్ బట్ ఆన్ ది అదర్ హ్యాండ్ యదోవాచో నివర్తంది అప్రాప్య మనసస్సగ వాట్ ఇట్ సేస్ యూ కెనాట్ ఎవాల్యుయేట్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ అబౌట్ ది భగవాన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ జస్ట్ లైక్ వాట్ ఐన్స్టీన్ వాస్ టెలింగ్ సైన్స్ ఈస్ లైక్ ఎ బిగ్ ఓషన్ ఐఎమ్ లైక్ ఎ స్మాల్ బాయ్ వాట్ పికింగ్ అప్ ది షెల్స్ క్లింజల్ పొరుకురా మరి దట్స్ ఆల్ వీఆర్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్స్ సచ్ ఎ హ్యూజ్ ఓషన్ భగవాన్ ఇస్ సచ్ ఎ హ్యూజ్ వన్ దర్ ఇస్ నో వే వీ విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వాట్ ఇట్ సేస్ వీ విల్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది హోల్ థింగ్ ఆఫ్ ది భగవాన్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఇట్ సేస్ ఇట్ డస్ నాట్ సే యూ విల్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ లైక్ నమ్మాళ్వార్ సేస్ భగవాన్ ఐ వాంటెడ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ఐ ట్రైడ్ వెరీ హార్డ్ ఫైనలీ ఐ అండర్స్టుడ్ యూ హౌ డూ ఐ అండర్స్టాండ్ యూ యూ ఆర్ బియాండ్ ఎనీ అండర్స్టాండింగ్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ యూ అండర్స్టూడ్ సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు యూస్ అవర్ నాలెడ్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ది భగవాన్ వట్ ఎవర్ వీ డూ ఇట్స్ ఓన్లీ వెరీ మినిస్క్యూల్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ దాట్ బట్ దట్ మినిస్క్యూల్ ఈస్ గుడ్ ఎనఫ్ ఫర్ అస్ టు గో అండ్ డూ ది ప్రపత్తి ఓకే సో ఇఫ్ భగవాన్ గివ్స్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ మణత్తోనే పట్టిండేనే లైక్ కులశేఖర ఆళ్వార్ ఆమోద స్తంభం రంగనాథన్ నాడు ఇఫ్ యూ గో అండ్ స్టాండ్ దిస్ ఈస్ ఆల్ దిస్ రాపత్ పగల్పత్ ఆర్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ So if you go to the Ranganatha Sannadhi, two pillars are there and you have to hold on to that one. That is what Kulasekara Aazhvar says. If you don't hold on to that, Bhagavan's Karuna Vellam, the floods are coming from compassion and it will throw you out all of them. So Amodastambam. Adamari, what we are understand very little, that is good enough. Okay. So Manacha, Manasa, Vachasa, Drishtya, Grihyade, Manasa. Manasa means the mind. మెంటల్ బుద్ధి ధర్మబుద్ధి జ్ఞానం వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ కెన్ థింక్ వచసా వాక్ వైజ్ స్పీచ్ టాకటివ్ వైజ్ ఆల్ దోస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ వచస. హియర్ వెన్ యు సే మనస, మనస్ ఇస్ వాట్ అందర్ ఇంద్రియం, ది 11th ఇంద్రియం యు గాట్ ఇన్ సైడ్. వచస మీన్స్ వాక్, వాక్ ఇస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ది కర్మేంద్రియం. సో వెన్ యు సే వచస మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ ఉపలక్షణం ఫర్ ఆల్ ది కర్మేంద్రియం. దృష్ట్యా, దృష్ట్యా మీన్స్ సైట్. వాట్ ది సైట్ డస్, ఇట్ బ్రింగ్స్ ది ఐటమ్స్ టు యూ, ఇట్ గివ్స్ యూ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఫర్ యూ. సో దట్ ఈస్ ది జ్ఞానేంద్రియం. సో వెన్ యు సే దృష్ట్యా, ఇట్ మీన్స్ ఉపలక్షణం ఫర్ ది ఆల్ ది జ్ఞానేంద్రియమ్స్. సో మనస వచస దృష్ట్యా, 1 + 5 + 5, 11 ఇంద్రియమ్స్ ఇట్స్ టాకింగ్. గృహ్యదే, ఇట్ ఈస్ పర్సీవ్డ్. సో యు ఆర్ పర్సీవింగ్ వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ, బ్రింగ్స్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్, బికాస్ దట్ ఈస్ వేర్ ది నెక్స్ట్ ఫ్యూ శ్లోగాస్ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు బి, వై ఐఎమ్ అట్రాక్టెడ్ టు ఆల్ ది థింగ్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఆన్సర్. సో ఈస్ బ్రింగింగ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్, మనస వచస దృష్ట్యా గృహ్యదే. వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ డూ పర్సీవ్డ్ విత్ ది 11 ఇంద్రియమ్స్ అండ్ యు ఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఆన్ ఇన్పుట్ అండ్ అవుట్పుట్. ఇన్పుట్ ఈస్ జ్ఞానేంద్రియం, అవుట్పుట్ ఈస్ ఏ కర్మేంద్రియం. అన్యై అభి ఇంద్రియై అభి ఆల్సో మోర్ అన్యై ఇంద్రియై అదర్ ఇంద్రియమ్స్. సీ దర్ ఇస్ నాట్ అదర్ ఇంద్రియం, ఓన్లీ 11 ఇంద్రియమ్స్. బట్ వెన్ ఐ సెడ్ వచస, యూ మీ నాట్ ఎక్స్టెండెడ్ దట్ ఓ దిస్ ఈస్ ఉపలక్షణం, ఐ గాట్ రెస్ట్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. ఓ వెన్ ఐ సే దృష్ట్యా, దిస్ ఉపలక్షణం ఫర్ జ్ఞానేంద్రియం, ఐఎమ్ ఎక్స్పాండింగ్. యూ మైట్ నాట్ హ్యావ్ ఆబ్వియస్లీ అండర్స్టూడ్. ఐ డోంట్ వాంట్ టు డూ దట్ వన్ క్యాచ్ ఆల్ ఫ్రేస్. ఇట్ సేస్ అభి అన్యై ఇంద్రియై ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. దర్ ఇస్ ఎ రీజన్ హియర్ ఆల్సో. వచస దృష్ట్యా ఇస్ ది ఉపలక్షణం ఫర్ ది కర్మ జ్ఞాన ఇంద్రియమ్స్ వి గాట్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. బట్ అన్యై అభి ఇంద్రియై మీన్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ ప్లేస్ వాట్ యు ఆర్ సీయింగ్, వాట్ యు ఆర్ ప్రాసెసింగ్ బేసికలీ ఈజ్ ది ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రమాణం. బట్ ది మైండ్, వాట్ ఎవర్ యు గాట్, ఓ 2 + 2 = 4, 4 + 4 = 8, ఇట్ ట్రై టు క్యాల్కులేట్, deduce and infer, that is basically anumanam. So here when he says anyaihi abhi indriyaihi, that may include manas is calculating all the deductions and inferences. So you have two pramanas, one is the pratyaksha pramana, other one is anumana pramana. But both of them, what do you understand? They may not show everything. That is the starting point of Sribhashyam. That is the starting point of Ragasatrasaram. That is the starting point of Bhagat Vishayam. All of them starting point is that. Why? Because three pramanas are there. Pramana and Prameya. That is how we started. The pramana, pratyaksham, anumanam, shabdam. Shabdam is the one basically some words which you have trust on that one. So the highest shabdam is Shruti and then Smriti, Idigasha Purana, Acharya, Alvars Pasuram, all those things are coming over there. So what the Pratyaksham and Anumana Pramana, they may be deceiving in some times, but Shabda Pramana will never do. So what these things, why is not including Shabdam? Vedaisya Sarvaihi అహమేవే వేద్యః, ఈ ఆల్రెడీ టోల్డ్ ఐఎమ్ ది వేదాస్. సో ప్రత్యక్షం అండ్ అనుమానం, వాట్ యు సీ, అహం ఏవ న మత్తః, అహం ఐ ఏవ ఇండీడ్ ఓన్లీ ఏవకారం. ఐ కీప్ ఆన్ టెలింగ్ భగవాన్ లవ్స్ దట్ వన్ వర్డ్ ఏవ, ఏవకారం. ఐఎమ్ ది ఓన్లీ వన్ ఆది బీజం, ఐఎమ్ నో టూ పీపుల్. సాటర్డే సండే సంబడి వర్క్స్ అండ్ వీక్ డేస్ ఐ వర్క్, or I sleep, or I retire, I go to, when I get old, none of them happens to him. Okay, he is all the time aham eva na matta, other than me there is nothing else. Now he is completing everything and coming back. What is this Sanagadeshwar? First we thought Brahman is the only thing that exists, and you come back and confused us, saying, no, there are many atmas are there. So we accepted that. Then we thought, I am different, he is different, he is different. Then you say, no, you are all not different, you are all one. So then you put the degam, all of them coming from Prakriti. Now when I look at you, you are like this one, like Amsarubam. Then you say, you are everything. I am the only thing exist. You go back into a circle to the first thing, what we were assuming. So that is what Brahman is giving, because all of them are correct. That is where the Khadaga Shruti is. How do you explain all of them? Oh, Amsa Bhagavan, you are really confusing me. Before the first sloka, I thought everything is one. You told me it is many. Now you are coming back and telling, actually what is confusing me, there's only one thing there. You alone exist. Are you one? Are you many? Are you one Atma or many Atma? Do you have one Sariram, many Sariram? When you talk about this one, they get really confused. Forget about you. Who am I? What is this person talking? I don't understand myself. Who am I? I don't really understand. That is what I want to tell you. Amsa says, I want you to understand, I want you to get confused who you are. When you get confused, then only you will get it. Very nicely, he brings the three, you started with the zero, go all the way and all of them, come back to the zero, saying that one, everything is mine. And if you look at all of them, all the Shruti Vakyams are there. In the three slogas, Sadeva Saumyedam Agrahasid Yegamevad Vidhiyam Chantokya Upanishad. Saumya, a young person, what is it? And to him, the father, Uttalagar is saying, Idam, this word, Agre, but is before the manifestation, Sat Eva, Evagaram, Sat Eva. Sat means Sat, Tat, Narayanan, Brahmam, everything is the same word. Okay, Sat means then Satyam. When you say that, it is coming from Sat, existing. That is true, that never changes. So Sat, na Asat arga abdina, there is no brain artham. So Sat, Sat Eva, only thing. Egam Eva Atvidiyam. One without the second. That is what? Sat Eva Egam Eva Atvidiyam. You said, Aham Eva Na Mataha. Put it one-to-one correspondence. Exactly the same. What it says over here, Amsa Bhagavan looking at him and is saying, you are asking about my Shariram. First we told about Atma. Second, I told about your body, Prakriti and everything. Now you are asking, what is my Shariram? Everything is my Shariram. The one you are talking, that is my Shariram. The one Atma you have, that one, that is my Shariram. That is where they got confused. This word does not say all of them. So it starts thinking about that. So many varieties of things are there. Veda Vakyams, all of them are there. All of them are correct. You cannot say one Veda Vakyam is wrong. All of them are correct. That is what the whole idea of Sri Bhashyam. To explain how to reconcile all those things. That's why Embarumanar's Sri Bhashyam is so great, because conflicting kind of things he brings and try to make a compromise and say, this is what the answer it has to be. We have to figure it out and answer, rather than saying, oh, these Vakyams are good, others you can neglect, you can throw them off. You cannot say, I love only two kids. I don't like seven of my kids. I disown them. You cannot tell they. You have to have all of them. So, Sati, Eva, Egameva, Atvidiyam. Aham, Eva, Namattaha. One to one. Same thing, Vacharambanam Vigaro, Namadeyam Ritigetya Satyam. That is one, he is overlapping. So every word of this Amsa Bhagavan over here, it corresponds to the Vedavakyam. Manasa Vachasa Drishtya Grihyade Anyaihi Abhi Indriyaihi. Here, he talked about Pratyaksham and Anumanam. Shabdam he did not tell. You don't have to tell. Sanagadis already mastered the Sabdam. They know what the Vedas are telling. Brahma mastered that one. They know all of them. So the one that is going to confuse you is these two, Pratyaksham Anumanam. That is only thing he took. Because that is what we got used to. We don't look at the Veda and try to find anything. We always look the eyes and then we find something and then we deduce. Because that's where the problem they have. They never have a problem on Vedas. They never said that one, can you explain this part of the Upanishad? They never said. They said the objects are there and my mind is going there. Objects are coming to me. What is that? That is Pratyaksham and Anumanam. So that is where you have a problem. And that has to be reconciled, determined and concluded with Veda Vakyams. So you studied Veda Vakyams separately and you are doing this. You are not joining those two. That is where Bhagavan is going to say, Rishis, you have studied a lot, but you never applied those things correctly. So that is the same thing. Uddhava Gita, the whole thing he says, you have done prabhatti, you are not acting according to your prabhannan. How do you reconcile that? That is why he is bringing all of them here. So, here, manasa, vachasa, drishtya, grihyade, anyai abhi indriyai. But you told in the second sloka, everything is pragrithi and it's manifested in everything. Yes, that is what I am trying to tell. What is this person A, this person B, this table C and this chair D? When you go to the pralayam, all of them would be the same. Okay? All of them came from there. All of them will go back. Srishti Anilayam. So that is why you have to understand everything what is created, manifested, will have an end. It will go back. When you have a birth, you will have a death of that. Things don't change. Very beautifully our Siddhantam says, you cannot create a new product. You cannot, what do you call, kill a product. It changes from one form to the other form. Okay? So, sukshma, chetana, achetana, brahmam, changing to the sthula, sukshma, sthula, chetana, achetana, brahmam. This sukshmam part becomes a sthulam part. That's the only thing. Everything else is the same. So, Krishna, Hamsa Bhagavan is answering Krishna's slogan there. Yadi dam manasa vacham. Chakshurbhyam shravanadibhihi nashwaram grihyamanancha nashwaram grihyamanancha. Up to that one he answered. Viddhi maya manomayam is going to answer the rest of them. Rest of the 20 slogas, Hamsa Bhagavan is going to answer how it is viddhi maya manomayam. Okay. So all of them are nashwaram, destructive items, perishable anything. Only thing, it manifests and it shrinks. So, in all the chetana, achetanam, I am present. Actually, I am the one manifesting, I am the one shrinking. Why? Tad aikshada bhagusyam prajaye yedi tattejo asurijadaha. We start in this Sri Bhashadla. So, what happens is Bhagavan made a sangalpam. Tad aikshada bhagusyam prajaye yedi. Let me be of many things. A potter is there, he is thinking, this is the clay, I am going to make the clay and make a pot. He is making a sangalpam to make a pot. So, after making the pot, pot is different, the potter, the guy who did is different. But Bhagavan, when he makes this srishti, I am going to make this srishti. Here is the prakriti, is it divatma, I make them. When he makes them, Bhagavan is the srishti, karyam. Karanam is, karyam is. Clay is the one, manifested pot and plate is the one. Gold is the one, when it's manifested into necklace and everything is the one. So this is where the third sloka I tries to understand. No. I am not bounded by this body. What you see, I am everywhere. So when I come as a Rama, when I come as a Krishna, don't think I am bounded by this 6 feet tall. I am not. That's not my boundary. That is what I present. So, when you are going and putting, see, when you are doing the Thirumanjanam, somebody was asking, the Shalagramam is so small. You take with this vattil and everything, you are putting, Sagasra Sirisha Purushaga, Sagasra Chasagasra Bhad. Oh, you are saying like that. Oh, this is a small salagramam. I am doing the aradhanam for this Bhagavan and everything. Never think of that. That is only a part of the Vishwam. The Bhagavan is spread everywhere. And this is only part you are looking at, that one. Similarly, Hamsa Bhagavan is smiling at them. When I say everything is my shariram over here, vyabhagatvam everywhere. First I told you there's a difference between you and me. Now I give the answer. When you say Jivatma, Paramatma different in first sloka, second sloka when I say that one shariram, that shariram is for you. You are bounded by that. Why? Because you are a Jivatma, you are Anutvam. When you go to the third sloka, Vyabhagatvam, that is me. So you strength to answer, go back to the first one. Now you understand, you are a Anu, I am a Vibhu. Look at these three slogans. Every part of Ragasitra Saram and Sri Bhashyam is already in there. The base is the fundamentals of this. If you don't understand this, there is no way I can clear your doubt about why my mind is always going into that temptation. Why that item is tempting me. I cannot answer that unless you understand. So, the basis for doing all of them is the Tattvatrayam, Shariraga Sastram. How do you do the Kadaga Shruti of making all of them connecting? Kadal Nyalam Seidene Ana Endrum, Kadal Nyalam Avenum Yane Endrum. When I manifest, when I make all this product, I am the product. I am the part. I am the necklace. That is what Bhagavan says. So everything you see is me. There's nothing other than me. Everything you are seeing. So that is why when they say Brahman is the only one exists, of course I accept, Embarumanar said. We cannot say wrong because that's a Shruti Vakyam. But that Brahman has got Atma and a Shariram. The Atma is called Paramatma. The Shariram is basically Chetana, Achetana, Vastu. The Chetana, Achetana, Vastu, the connection to the Bhagavan is Abhrudak Siddhi. Abhrudak Siddhi means you cannot separate them. Bhagavan cannot exist without the body. We are all. And we cannot exist without Bhagavan. Nee indri naan illai, naan indri nee illai, like Alvar said. So beautifully in the three things, the fundamentals of our sastram, from the Sariraga sastram viewpoint he has put. Then he says, Anyat idi buddhyatvam anyasaha. Anyat. Anything else. Buddhyatvam. You should understand. If somebody says, I told you these three slokas, if somebody says anything else, angyasa, you should be able to deduct, directly coming to the analysis of this solution, idi. What is idi? What I told you in this. These three slokas, what I told you, if anybody gives you any other Vedavakyam, any other Upanishad, you should be able to derive to this one. The whole sastram in three slokas. And anything else is based on this one only. Krishna gave seven slokas, but Hamsa Bhagavan gave only three slokas. So, Vedas and Upanishad may talk differently, but you should understand there are apparent contradictions, apparent conflict. But your knowledge, your judgment, your analysis, you go through that one, come to the same conclusion. What is the conclusion you come over here? What I told you in three? First of all, Paramatma and Jivatma are different. Paramatma does not need any refuge. He is the cause of everything. And what we have, the Shariram. The Shariram is made up of Prakriti, all of them same. Okay? So, and then, finally, I have you as Atma, you as the Prakriti, all of them as my Shariram. So this is what it says. I am the boss. You are all different because I am the Paramatma. Two, you are all made up of same thing. What is that? Achetana Vastu. But I have ears, eyes everywhere. Vyabhagatvam. So if you have any doubt whether the Bhagavan knows or not, Bhagavan kakarni rukha, abdina, I have the eyes everywhere. I have the ears everywhere because I am spread everywhere. Very beautifully these three slogans he says. So, when you go out, that's why Parashara Maharishi was saying, when you are looking at anything, I don't see anything other than Bhagavan. Jodimsi Vishnuhu, Bhuvanani Vishnuhu, Jalani Vishnuhu, Nirpadellam Nedumale, Alvar says that one. So, all you have to understand, everything you see is only me. Nilaidanda Naraganai, Niyamikkum Yerevanumai, Iladu Ondru Enavagai Ellam Thanadenum Endayumai. இலது ஒன்று இல்லை என தர் இஸ் நத்திங் தட் டஸ் நாட் பிலாங் டு ஹிம் இன் தட் வே எவ்ரி திங் பிலாங்ஸ் டு ஹிம் ஈ கோஸ் டு தி ஆப்போசிட் கம்ஸ் பேக் ஸோ பகவான் ஓன்ஸ் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் ஸோ பட் நத்திங் கேன் எக்ஸிஸ்ட் செப்பரேட்லி ஃப்ரம் ஹிம் யூ கெனாட் எக்ஸிஸ்ட் வித்தவுட் ஹிம் வி ஆர் வாட் யூ கால் அஸ் அ பார்ட் அண்ட் பார்சல் ஆஃப் தி லார்ட் How you can explain the way each of the Jivatma is like a cell in the body. All the cells put together becomes the body, Shariram for Bhagavan. So each one is a part of Bhagavan. There is a Bhagavan there. Bhagavan is inside sitting over here. So Narayana Padam, when we give the Vyakhyanam for that one, he is inside me when we say that one. So we are Bhagavan. But a part of that one, he is sitting over there. So we are not the total Bhagavan. A cell cannot say, I am the total body. But all the cells put together, that is where the body that belongs to the Bhagavan. So that is the visitare, the Siddhantam, that is what the Amsa Bhagavan is explaining over here. Bhagavan is testing the intelligence of the sages, the four sages you are coming over here. I tried to start with something what you thought is wrong. Finally, I come back to and saying what you think is right. That they don't understand. Am I right or I am wrong? Who am I? I don't understand at all myself. First, forget about who are you, the question I ask you. Please forgive me. We have to ask, who am I? So, Jivatma Paramatma Tattvam, Tattvam Therinjada, you can go for the Purushartham, and the Upayam. How beautifully it starts. It does not go to the Purushartham first. Understand who you are, understand who am I, then only we will talk where you can go and all of them. Very nice three slogans, very heavy materials. Sit there and keep on thinking, pondering over these three. That is where you will understand. Amsa Bhagavan's answer is not a direct answer. He did not say, I am the Paramatma, you are the Jivatma, you belong to me, you are a slave to me. He did not say that. He is very cryptic, just like a Brahma Sutra, very convoluted way of telling. Instead of answering directly, he talks first at the Atma level. In the second sloka, he compares with the Sariram level. Because Bhagavan comes to the Leela Vibhuti, just like Krishna and Rama, we think, oh, he is like one of us. Because he is staying in that form, doesn't mean that's the only form he has got. Okay? At the same time, like Parasara Maharishi says, Andantu Sagasrani Kodi Kodi Sadani Cha, when he says, trillions of andams, universes are there. Each universe, there is a Brahma. So, Ramavadaram is happening here. Krishnavadaram may be in some other Brahma's universe. And Varagavadaram somewhere else. Simultaneously can happen. That is based on the space. Time-wise, if you look at how many Brahmas have come, like he says, you can calculate the rainwater drops, how many of them you can calculate them. But you cannot calculate how many Brahmas I have created. So, that many things are over there. Bhagavan's total srishti, when you look at, there is no way to comprehend. If you cannot comprehend the srishti padartham, the purul, the thing, the intelligence of the Bhagavan, the nature of him, the surubam of him, there is no way we can identify. That is what Hamsa Bhagavan wants to point out. First, you are so infinitesimally small, such a micro level. I am such a high level. If you understand this part, then only we go to the Upayam and Purushartham. Okay? So, the problem here is, when Hamsa Bhagavan comes and stands in front, they is asking, who are you? This is almost like in a jail, that's a prisoner is sitting, that's a warden is there. Both of them are in the jail, but there is a difference. At the evening 5 o'clock, warden goes back to his house. You are always in jail. So Krishna comes over here, Rama comes over here, Hamsa comes over here, and he says, you are in the Prakriti Mandalam, Samsaram, you will always be there. I am the warden, I will go out. Okay, that we cannot compare. That is why they are asking, who are you? Thinking, I am like you? No, I am not. I am the one put you in the jail. I am the one can take you from the jail. That is secondary. But I don't belong to the same jail all the time. I can go out. So the warden and the prisoner in the jail, they are different. That is where Desikan takes in the Ragasatra Saram. So one endures a permanent punishment. One is the boss leaving that one. So even the Shariram, when I stand before you, don't compare. My one is Aprakritam. Yours is the Prakriti Sambandham. Even Krishna comes over here. That is why we say the Shanagramam we have and the Utsavamurti and Moolavamurti in the temple, they are all Aprakritam. They are all beyond the Prakriti Mandalam. So even Shariram, don't compare. Prakriti is my Vasham. You are Prakriti Vasham. That is his starting point to answer him. So you are Prakriti Vasham. I am holding the Prakriti. Prakriti answering me. So if you want to win the Prakriti, the only way you can do is come to me. How beautifully he brings that one. So Krishna in the first slokam says, Tum ta sarvam parityacha snegam sojana bandushu. Krishna, you say that. How can I do that? Mayi aveshya manasamyaku. He said, put it on me. Krishna told very, very nicely, as affectionately, says, put it on me. Why should I put it on you? People ask. Hamsa Bhagavan says, you don't have no other choice. I am the only one controlling. Daivi esha gunamayi mama maya duradyaya. I am the one controlling the Prakriti. Understand, the Prakriti is the one that is going to cause all the problems for you. And you should be able to separate you and the Prakriti. And the Prakriti is Mayamayam Manomayam. That is what the answer is going to come to. Very wonderful three slogans when you look at this one. Two things essentially he wants to tell. One, I am the Lord Supreme. Never compare you and me. Okay? Second one, I own the Prakriti. You have to win the Prakriti. That's all the answer you are trying. So if you win the Prakriti, you go to the moksha. Okay? If you don't win the Prakriti, you are in samsara, falling down. Same thing what we saw, Sukshma Nadi, when we go through Sibarshim and everything, so you fall down over here. So, indirectly is bringing some of the three things what we saw, Sariratma Brahmam, Swadandratma Brahmam, Anya Devada Paratva Buddhi. All of them is bringing inside over here. We will parse all of them and see in the next few slogans also. So, if you don't understand I am the Supreme, you are Prakriti Vasam. And you need me to get out of this Prakriti. If you don't understand, you will not have a Sattva Gunam. If you don't have a Sattva Gunam, how are you going to enhance the Sattva Gunam? Enhancing the Sattva Gunam, that is the only way you can do. That is what he was saying. Now, after the three questions he answered, the Sanakadis got totally confused. They could not understand who they are. The whole idea, the answering, that should create more kind of confusion inside you, more question, more puzzles and everything coming out. That's where you will start thinking. Now Bhagavan is going to answer. Several slogans are there. And here, very beautifully, first we had to give a little more psychology before we go anywhere inside. Let's go through the first sloga and the padams, and then I will give the details. Guneshva vishade chedo gunas chedasischa prajaham jivasya deha ubayam ಗುಣಾಶ್ಚೇದೋ ಮದಾತ್ಮನಃ ಗುಣೇಶ್ವಾ ವಿಷದೇ ಚೇದೋ ಗುಣಾಶ್ಚೇದಿಸಿ ಸಪ್ರಜಾಃ ಜೀವಸ್ಯ ದೇಹ ಉಭಯಂ ಗುಣಾಶ್ಚೇದೋ ಮದಾತ್ಮನಃ. ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿ ಹಂಸ ಭಗವಾನ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಎ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ಭಗವಾನ್ ರಿಪೀಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್? ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ಲೆಸನ್. ಸಂಬಡಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಎ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ವಿ ವುಡ್ ಬಿ ಆನ್ಸರಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಅನ್ ಅವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಐ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕ್ವಶನ್, ದಿ ಶ್ಲೋಕ ಹಿಯರ್, ಪ್ರಜಾ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸನ್ಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಸನಕಾದೀಸ್ ಛೇದಃ ಆವಿಷದೇ ಗುಣೇಶು. ಚೇತಃ, ಚೇತಃ ಮೀನ್ ಚೈತನ್ಯಂ. ಚೈತನ್ಯಂ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್. ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆನ್ಸ್, ಮೈಂಡ್, ಬುದ್ಧಿ. ಆವಿಷದೇ, ಆವಿಷದೇ ಮೀನ್ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್, ಆವೇಶಂ ರಮರಿ ಎಂಟರಿಂಗ್, ಅಪ್ಟೈನಿಂಗ್, ಅಪ್ರೋಚಿಂಗ್, ಗೋ ಟು ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಆವಿಷದೆ ಗುಣೇಶು, ಗುಣೇಶು ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ವಿಷಯಂ. ಗುಣೇಶು ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವಿಷಯಂ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ದೇ. ಛೇದಃ ಆವಿಷದೆ ಗುಣೇಶು, ಮೈಂಡ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಕ್ವೈಟ್, ದಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಮೈಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್, ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸಿವ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯು ಸೀ ದರ್ಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಜಿಲೇಬಿ ಓವರ್ ದೇರ್. ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ವೈಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ದಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಥಿಂಕಿಂಗ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್, ಮೇ ಬಿ ಟೂ, ಮೇ ಬಿ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಎಟ್ 6 o'clock ಆರ್ 8 o'clock, ಮೇ ಬಿ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ವೆನ್ ದಿ ವೈಫ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ವೆನ್ ಶಿ ಗೋಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ರೂಮ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್. ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್. ಸೊ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್, ದಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಸೊ ಔಟ್ಸೈಡ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ಛೇದಗ ಆವಿಷದೆ ಗುಣೇಶು. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಚ ಗುಣಾಹ ಛೇದಸಿ. ಚ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಗುಣಾಹ, ದಿ ವಿಷಯಂ, ದಿ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಛೇದಸಿ, ದೇ ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಮೈ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಸಿ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ಲಿ ತಿರುವಾರಾಧನ. ಹೂ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದಿ ಕಾಫಿ? ವೆನ್ ಶಿ ಮೇಕ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಕಾಫಿ, ನೈಸ್ ಸ್ಮೆಲ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ನೋಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ಬಟ್ ಯು ಪುಲ್ಡ್, ದಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪುಲ್ಡ್. ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ದಿ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಅಚೇತನ ವಸ್ತು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪುಲ್ಡ್ ಇಮ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಒನ್. ನೌ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್, ಚ ಗುಣಾಹ ಛೇದಸಿ. ಸೊ ನಾಮ ರೂಪ ವಸ್ತುಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ನಾಮ ರೂಪ ವಸ್ತು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಫಿ ವಸ್ತು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರಾಗ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಯು. ಸೊ ದಿ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್. ಇಟ್ ಕುಡ್ ಬಿ ದಿ ಅದರ್ ವೇ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಸಿ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಮೇ ಬಿ ಕಾಮ್. ಸೊ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸುಮಾ ಅಲಮ್, ಯು ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೇ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಹಿಮ್, ದಟ್ ಗೈ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಚ್ ಯು ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದೇರ್. ಸೊ ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ಯು ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಹಿಚ್ ಯು. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ವಿ ಡೂ. ಇನಿಷಿಯಲಿ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸಿಟಿಂಗ್, ನೋಬಡಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಯು ಗೋ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಮಾವ್, ದಿ ಫ್ಲವರ್, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಶುಗರ್, ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಗೀ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದಿ ವಸ್ತು, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ವಸ್ತು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ಈಟ್ ಇಟ್, ಯುವರ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಅಪ್. ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಐಟಮ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸಿವ್, ಕ್ವಯಟ್. ಯು ಆರ್ ದಿ ಒನ್ ಇಂಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಯುವರ್ ಶುಗರ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಅಪ್. ಓ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್, ದಿಸ್ ಜಿಲೇಬಿ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಹ್ಯೂಜ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಜಿಲೇಬಿ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ದಿ ಒನ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಯು ಮೇಡ್ ದಿ ಜಿಲೇಬಿ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟು ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಗಾಟ್. ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆಡ್ ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲಿ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಶೋ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಮ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಡ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗ್ ಟು ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಯು ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿ ಸೇಮ್ ವೇ. ಗುಣೇಶ್ವಾ ವಿಷದೇ ಛೇದೋ ಗುಣಾಶ್ಚೇದಸಿ ಚ ಪ್ರಜಾಃ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್, ಮೈಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಸಿವ್, ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಥಿಂಗ್ ನ್ಯೂ. ಭಗವಾನ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಪೀಟಿಂಗ್, ಯು ಮೂವ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಯು. ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ವಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸಂಸಾರಿ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್. ವೈ ಯು ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಸಂಸಾರಿ? ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿ ಸುಖ ದುಃಖಮ್ಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎಂಜಾಯಿಂಗ್. Kartutvatyagam, Mamadatyagam, Palatyagam, Palavahityagam, everything is derived from here, Deshigan. So that is what he is going to say. We become samsari. Why? Because we think ownership. Okay? We have the bhogyatvam. So we think that we are enjoying that one. So what the Sanagadi is asked earlier, putting the same thing, this is the premises. Okay? This is the background. This is given. And remaining the question is that you are asking for. So now he is going to answer that one. Amsa Bhagavan answering directly to this question. What is the question? Objects attracting me. My mind goes to the object. How would I get the out of the entanglement? He is going to answer with 2-3 slokas. And then he is going to show how to train your mind. That is what the rest of them is going to talk. The answer for this one, we can, second part of this one is the answer and the next sloka. But we close this one, we understand what he is going to talk. Krishna loved saying Sangam, Satsangam. He was saying that. Hamsa Bhagavan comes with the opposite of that. He says Asangam. The most important for you is Asangam. You have to separate. What is this? One says you have to go and join and everything do. Now you are telling, see, that is where everything is conflicting part. But the way how you look, the way you parse, the way you interpret, that is how the smartness is there. So the asangaha, separation, that is what he is going to say. So the separation part is going to give two ways. The answer to that one, you are asking in two ways. The first step in the asangam, it is asangam. Second step is in jnanam. So you need asangam, you need jnanam. The rendu one. The asangam, first let me tell you. What is asangam means? Separation. How the separation would come? You try to refrain, renunciate, give up, dispassion, throw it away, go away, move away. All of them is going to be the first step. The first step we can do two ways. We are going back to the Nayaganayananda Nandagopanudaya Pasuram. Okay? Rishikesan. Okay? How can you do the asangam? Asangam can be done, separation, by two ways. One, physically. Two, mentally. Let's take physically. So, you use your external indriyams and you physically move out of that one. That is Dhamaha. Second one, mentally you are going out of that one, that is Samaha. Okay? So, what I am trying to advise you, Sanagadi, is two-prong approach. First prong, put a band-aid first. That is what I am going to. Then take him to the hospital and they will do take care of that. So, the band-aid process is the first step. Second step is the jnanam. Asangam is basically first one, band-aid process. So, let us take an ordinary situation. In the house, you see your wife and a kid. Both of them arguing. Then you look at, look, listen to me. Why don't you go to your room? You say it to him. You tell to one of them, go to your room. You try to physically separate them. He may not understand why dad is saying and he said the anger. Or why the spouse is saying, they may not. But you are forcing them to go. I will tell you later. Go now. That is a band-aid approach. If you are trying to tell, your mother is very important. Matru Devo Bhava. He is not in that mood to understand that. So we need a band-aid first. Jnanam comes later. So that is what the first one. Just to do what I am telling you. You will understand later. Okay, that is the first one. The second one, alternate one, or you can tell to your wife, well, he's a small boy, he's talking something, just bite your teeth and wait. Don't put everything into your ears. Well, you're controlling the mind. Even though she is present, the small boy is arguing and telling all of them, nothing goes inside because she has got the mind control. Samam. First one is a damam, second one is a samam. You may need both of them. Okay, you may need both of them. I remember first time when I went to the Hare Krishna temple in back in Boston, that was about 35 years back. So at that time, when you go in there, before you leave, they shut the doors, lock it. So you have to stay there and get the prasadam, and then only you can leave. Okay, so mentally you have to be with them. Whatever it is happening, physically you cannot move, mentally you are forced to be with the Bhagavan. Same thing, sometimes we go to the Dolai, we cannot come out. You have to get the Tirtham and Prasadam, you have to wait. So mind, you have to do that one. Same thing with Ekadashi. Mind, you cannot eat, the clock is not next day. So that one. So sometimes you do. Sometimes you get angry with your wife. What do you do? I go and take a walk. So you get out. Yesterday somebody was put, somebody got angry with the wife. They walked, 452 kilometers he walked. So one of the news, it says, similar to that one, what you do, the easiest one is, or you go to the basement and do the punch bag. Go and hit on that. So you divert yourself, your indriyam, somewhere else. So the two methods, what we have told, one is the damam, the other one is samam. Damam is the indriyam part of that. Samam is the mind part of that one. So, don't look, don't hear, all these things. Mind always thinking of that, physically separating that one. If you are physically separated, not much you can do. Not much you can do. When people get angry, get away from that place. When you try to get mad on somebody, get away from that place. That's the easiest one. But the second one, dama, I cannot leave. The problem is not with that one. It is internal, not external. So if it is inside you, you have to start doing something. I don't know. I keep on looking at in the Dolai, one person, one Bhagavata, one this one is not good, or something that comes there. So don't think that. Go to the Dhyanam, go to the Slogam, go to the Nama Sankirtanam. Change your mind. Okay? That is where. So mind is always going into some kind of the unwanted thoughts. You cannot stop that one. But you can divert that one. So change that one, all of them. So sometimes mind may be violent. You have to change all of them. These are the two band-aid approach. Immediate solution. We can handle that one. You cannot give jnanam immediately. To for Sanagadis, that is what he is saying. Why? Because when you study the Vedam, it gives the jnanam. That is not important. Pratyaksha anumanam, that is what we need. So that is the two pramanam Mamsa Bhagavan takes, and he gives the band-aid approach. The jnanam is going to come from the Sapta Pramanam later on. Okay. So the jnanam, we will talk about the upadhi, and we talk about Brahmam, delusion, imposting, and all those kinds of imposter. That is all those kinds of words. And we will start and give some more explanation going into this. Amsa Bhagavan says, second part of this sloka and the following sloka. That is a compact answer he is giving, how you can handle the problem, how you can handle the temptations. We'll stop here. కవిధార్కిక సింహాయ కళ్యాణ గుణశాలిని శ్రీమదే వెంకటేశాయ వేదాంత గురవే నమః శ్రీమదే నిఘమాంత మహాదేశిగాయ నమః అడియనడియ